Hi, the following presentation takes us through the topic of finance function. Now, what is the function of finance? A million-dollar question. We understood about what is finance. We also understood what is meant by financial management. We also went through the categories of finance. What is the function of all this? Basically, if you put all the functions of finance together under one umbrella, the umbrella should seem something like this. It concerns with the acquisition and the utilization of funds necessary for efficient operations. Well, this is not all. This is just the beginning. So you acquire funds and then you utilize them for efficiently running the business, expanding the business, and so on and so forth. There are four major decisions which are involved under finance functions. Let's take them one by one. Let's understand them one by one. To start with, the first decision and the biggest decision is the investment decision. What is an investment? Investment means a spend which gives the business long-term returns. In fact, which gives anyone long-term returns. There's where an investment differentiates itself from expenditure. So any spend which gives an individual or a business long-term returns is an investment. Hence, it is essential that an investment decision, howsoever made, should create revenue for the business. It should generate profits and it should lead to cost reduction. What do investment decisions normally involve? The same thing as we have been discussing all this while. Where to put company's funds, how to arrange for working capital, how to budget that capital, whether there's a requirement for mergers, whether one should buy an asset or lease the asset, and so many others. These are the investment decisions. After you've invested the money and the business has started running, next comes the dividend decisions. What are dividends? Dividends are profits shared with the shareholders of the company. That profit sharing or that profit which is shared with the shareholders is called as dividend. Now, when a company makes profit, it is not essential that the company distributes its entire profit to its shareholders. If it does so, how will the company expand? So, it is very essential for a company to decide how much to share with the shareholders, how frequently it should share with the shareholders, and in what form? When we say in what form, should it give the money in the form of cash or in other forms? As we proceed further in this course, you will understand the various forms in which dividend can be given out to the shareholders. It is essential that there is a balance struck between the profits made by the company and profits shared by the company with its shareholders. While it is essential for the company to share its profits with the shareholders, it is not mandatory that the entire profits are shared. So there has to be a balance struck between the total profits versus the profits shared as dividends. Now, what does this picture depict? This looks like a dream, isn't it? You open the tap and money starts flowing out. You close the tap and the money stops flowing out. Well, does it symbolize liquidity of money? That's exactly what we are discussing here. Liquidity decisions. For a business, it's very important that they have liquid funds available. When we say liquid funds, we mean funds in hard cash. Okay, it's essential because there are certain payments or certain spends which have to be paid up immediately. Okay, and for that, it is essential that the company has enough funds to pay its bills, it should have enough cash reserves, it should have enough current assets. Now, I don't think I need to introduce current assets here. I presume that you all know what are current assets. Nevertheless, current assets are those kind of assets which can be easily convertible to cash. Liquidity decisions of a company prevent company from insolvency. Insolvency as in a state equivalent to bankruptcy, where the company becomes is not in a position to pay out its debts or its obligations because it has run out of cash. Again, details in the upcoming slides or in the future course. As of now, this is essential. This is all. You will understand liquidity more in the upcoming slides. Very important decision, the financing decision. We've already discussed a portion of this when we were doing business finance. We would reiterate financing decisions here. Two ways in which a company raises finance, debt and equity. We are not going through the entire explanation again. Debt is in the form of borrowed funds. Obviously, equity is owner's capital. Now, those owners can be angel investors, can be shareholders, can be promoters, and many others. Then two terms for which capital can be raised. Short term, which means for expenses of shorter durations, and short term capital is normally called as working capital. Okay, and long term, anything which is more than 1 year is categorized under long term. Certain classifications also classify this short term and long term into one more classification, which is mid term. So any financing decision which is made for a year or less is a short term decision. Anything more than that is a long term or a mid term and a long term subsequently. Well, that's what the slide says, and that's it for now.